Today we're going to be shooting Prince Rupert's drops out of a shotgun, and even Destin from Smarter Every Day asked us to do this. Hi, this is Jeff of Tal Flatermouse. I've been planning to shoot Prince Rupert drop for probably 6 months, and here I am making some of them. Now these are made by heating up a glass rod with a torch, drop it into water, and it creates these things. The outside of the glass cools much quicker than the inside, and it creates a strong compressive force that makes these things extremely strong. Now we can actually see the internal stresses of this, and it's very complex when viewed using a polarized filter. So how do you shoot something like this out of a shotgun and be able to see it with the high-speed cameras? So I simply colored it red using a red Sharpie pen, and in order to shoot these out of a shotgun I had to load it backwards with the tail facing forwards. Let's see if it works or not.
All right, welcome back to another episode of the Tal Flatermouse channel, where today, based on your request, we are shooting the Prince Rupert's drop. Jeff built these hardened glass drop into water, colored them with a little bit of red so that hopefully we can see them going downrange. We've got a little break in the air from the U.S. Navy has suspended all operations just for us. So we're going to go ahead and load these up and see how they work. They're unbelievably light, so we don't think they're going to go very far. So we started with a pretty short distance here. Doug Hickok is going to be wearing his vest down there, and we'll see what they do.
Okay, shot one. Hit it.
Holy crap. Did anything happen? That was sort of a shooting blanks. Holy crap.
We started out with the smallest Prince Rupert's drop, and it did hit the vest. It was hard to tell when we were shooting it, but as you can see, it didn't even break when it hit.
This one's a little larger. We'll see how that works out.
It's not the size, Jeff.
Oh, okay.
That's how it shoots.
It'll shoot a steel plate. Stainless steel, actually. If you had a brake action, you know that?
Oh, or prunes.
Never mind. All right, stainless steel plate. Anytime. Oh, that was dead on. I think it shattered, though.
Now you can see why I colored the Prince Rupert's drops all red, because it's, with all that other junk flying in the air, it would have been hard to distinguish what was going on. But as you can see, hitting that real hard stainless steel surface, it was definitely enough force to just shatter the Prince Rupert's drop into just super fine dust.
Okay, armed.
Yeah. Okay, ballistic gel gummy bear.
All right, on the nose.
Okay, hit it. That one, I think that one missed.
The nose.
Okay, hit it.
Now, as you can see, these things were not very predictable in their flight. The little tail probably influenced them in a certain way, so we had a couple misses. But we'll show them anyway.
That seemed like a nothing burger out of
that. That was very weak.
Now, this one did hit the ballistic gel gummy bear. It didn't stick in it. Didn't have a whole lot of velocity. But it bounced off the gummy bear, basically landed back by our feet again.
Okay, a slightly larger Prince Rupert drop. Okay, I'm ready. There we go.
That one had a little more pop to it also.
Finally, we had a good shot. It had a little higher velocity this time. And look at that thing just kind of disappear into that ballistic gel. Pretty cool.
Be careful, because those things are really sharp.
Yeah, yeah. So I was aiming for the tip of his nose, and I'll be damned if it didn't hit the tip of his nose. And as I'm feeling around here, there's actually a piece of the tail of glass is sticking out right there. So I'm trying to bring it out of here.
You almost grab the tail, but stab your finger with it too.
Yeah. It's just so slick, and it's...
Oh, okay.
It kind of wants to...
I think it would have... People are going to be, this is graphic, folks.
Yeah.
Graphic gummy bear violence.
Put myself with it. There it is. do that.
Harder than gummy bear.
That's almost completely intact though.
Yeah.
Very, very tip maybe.
Yeah. Didn't shatter once it hit. What about the block of clay with the biggest one?
Let's give it a try.
Okay, I'm ready.
Good. Oh,
right in the move.
It looks like he's going woo.
Right in the mush.
So Clay took it right in the mouth. There's a wad. You can see that the Prince Rupert drop left a little red on the peeled back clay here. Shape of the wad in a pretty deep
hole. Did it
go
through?
It didn't go through. I also don't see it. Nope, I do see it in there.
You could like slice it open or whatever, like peeing outdoors nine.
Yeah, peeing outdoors.
Peeing outdoors, whatever. You're gonna ruin your knife, dull it, I tell you.
You want your clay hard, from what I hear. So again, just like that last one, we've got a completely intact Rupert's drop.
So, what's the conclusion here?
They are not home defense rounds. For all the YouTubers that think that we're out here always testing out the ultimate home defense round, no. A lot of times these are just for fun. We're just trying to see what things will do when shot out of a shotgun. So the Rupert's drop was fun, but no, you're not going to use it on bad guys in your house.
And you're not going to use it in war either. So
no,
it's not a violation of the Geneva Convention.
Or the Hague Convention, just to be clear on that.
So we're not going to take them into World War I.
No. We've consulted the Tal Fledermaus attorneys, and it turns out that these are not in violation.
Let me get a close-up of that. There you go. Stronger than dirt.
Now, I didn't think these would even survive the shock of being shot out of the gun. I thought they'd just be dust coming out of the barrel. So it was a surprise to me that they not only survived that, but also survived impacting all these targets.
Doesn't even... There he goes. Oh, he's been hit. I think one of our slugs hit him.